6 minute English
from BBC Learning English.
Hello, I'm Sam, and welcome to 6 minute English. This is the program where, in just 6 minutes, we discuss an interesting topic and teach some related English vocabulary. Joining me to do this is Rob.
Hello, and today we're talking about fraud.
Fraud is the criminal activity of getting money by deceiving people or tricking people by doing something dishonest.
There are many ways to do this, and much of it is happening online these days.
We'll talk more about this in a moment, but first, a very honest quiz question for you to answer, Rob. According to UK Finance, an organisation that represents the British banking industry, how much money did criminals steal through fraud and scams last year? Was it A, £1.2 million, B, £120 million, or C, £1.2 billion?
Well, I imagine it's quite a lot, so I'll say £120 million.
Okay, we'll find out if you're right later in the programme. Now, I just mentioned the word scam, which is an illegal way of making money by tricking someone. We may think that we'll never be scammed, but already millions of people have fallen for fake emails, phone calls, or letters that look genuine and ask us to give or update our financial details.
To fall for means to believe something that is a trick or a lie to be true. This year, for example, thousands of people in the UK fell for a fraudulent or fake email requesting that people update their direct debit details for paying their TV licence. That's a payment we have to make in the UK to fund the BBC.
And this is something the BBC Radio 4 programme You and Yours has been discussing. Its BBC fraud investigator reporter Shari Val explained why it was easy to be deceived.
It's a sleight of hand fraud. The criminals get you to look over there whilst they rifle your pockets. And I have the email here, and it looks completely convincing. All the right logos, all the right fonts. It just says that my direct debit on my TV licence has failed and I need to pay it. It's very polite.
So some great language there. She said that this scam was a sleight of hand fraud. Sleight of hand means the use of clever skill to gain something dishonestly. In this case, money.
As Shari said, the criminals get you to, metaphorically, look over there whilst they rifle your pockets. Rifle means search something in order to steal from it. So to steal from your pocket, very dishonest.
Now, like in this case, fraudsters, the people who commit fraud, gained financial information by phishing. That's not phishing using a rod, line and hook, but by sending an email that looked like it came from your bank, asking for confidential information.
But banks do warn us not to give away our financial details online and to change our passwords regularly.
But sometimes criminals are very clever in what they do, and it's easy to be fooled. The You and Yours programme also heard about this from social engineer Jenny Radcliffe. What does she call this type of fraud?
The more sophisticated frauds are ones that have been thought through very carefully. And this has been thought through is a fraud that can be layered. So, you know, we're getting some information from you. What you really look for is a window into someone, a key that unlocks just a small part of their identity or their personal data. And from that, a good fraud will build and build and build on it until the consequences to some people can be completely devastating.
So Jenny Radcliffe is talking about sophisticated fraud. That means it's clever and often complicated, so it can confuse us.
Yes, criminals need just a small piece of information about us, a key that can eventually open up our identity and expose our personal data.
And as Jenny says, for the victims of fraud, the consequences, the outcome, can be very bad, especially if somebody loses all their hard-earned savings. It can be devastating.
Of course, banks and security companies are working hard to beat the criminals, but it still remains a problem. And earlier, I asked you, Rob, according to UK Finance, how much money did criminals steal through fraud and scams last year?
And I said B, £120 million. That's a lot of money.
It is, but it's even more. In 2018, criminals successfully stole £1.2 billion through fraud and scams. And that's just in the UK. Globally, it's even more.
Well, it certainly is a serious issue, but hopefully we haven't deceived you with the vocabulary we've discussed today.
Hopefully not. We've been talking about fraud. That's the criminal activity of getting money by deceiving people or tricking people by doing something dishonest.
Next, we had scam, which is an illegal or dishonest way of making money by tricking someone. The people who do it are scammers.
We talked about the phrasal verb fall for. When you fall for something, you believe something that is a trick or a lie to be true.
Then we heard about sleight of hand, which means use of clever skill to gain something dishonestly, and rifle, which means search something in order to steal from it.
Phishing, spelt with a PH, means tricking someone by email or online to get their personal data by pretending to be from your bank. Finally, we discussed sophisticated fraud. When something is sophisticated, it's clever and often complicated.
Unlike our program, Sam.
Let's hope so. But now we've reached the end of our program.
See you again soon. Bye.
Bye.
6 Minute English
from BBC Learning English.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. We have many more exciting videos to help you improve your English. So be sure to subscribe to our channel to get the full experience of our YouTube channel. See you there!